Go check out fifacoinsonline.com for great deals on getting coins, a quick, reliable and trustworthy site. Hey guys, CodyBoat3 here and welcome to this trading method video. Now today I want to show you exactly how to trade with kits. And I'm going to show you the method first and then some kits that I've actually picked up and what they sold for and a couple little things like that. Now I did put this method into practice back in FIFA 12, so I knew that it worked in that game, but whether it would work in FIFA 13 was a different question altogether. And I am glad to say it does in fact work. Now for this example, I will show you a couple examples, the first one being Man United. The first thing we need to do is check what the lowest buy now is on it. Now that is vitally important because kit prices are always changing every single day. They'll go up, they'll go down, depends on supply and demand really. So we find there that it is around 750 to 800 depending, sometimes it might be a bit lower, but around 750 or 800. And what I'll do is I'll search a maximum price of a couple hundred just below that, and literally what you're going to see me doing right here is bidding on every single kit up to an hour. And I always do that, guys. It is the most handy method, and especially with something like kits, because not a lot of people are bidding on them, you will find that you will pick up a lot more. And I don't really differentiate between the home and away, because it seemed like there was a couple of home ones, a couple of away ones in there with the lowest buy now, so they don't go for a difference in price, I suppose, with the kits. But the next kit that I am going to show you, there is a difference between the home and away, so just keep that in mind when you are putting bids in on the kits. And one thing I gotta say, guys, is usually what I'll do is I'll put a bid in on a load of them up to an hour, as I'm doing here, and then what I'll go and do is I'll just take a break, I'll go off Ultimate Team, and I won't get drawn into any bidding wars for them, because you'll find that the less you'll make, less and less profit. And I think I bidded on 100 in total, I want to say around 100 between the couple of different kits that I used, and I won, I think it was just over 30, around 32, 33, so it was a decent amount. Like if you can win 30% of something where you don't even have to end up in 15 second bid wars, that is absolutely amazing. And you'll see the next example was indeed Barcelona. Again, the first thing I always do is check the lowest buy now, and that also gives me an indicator of how much I can sell the kit on for once I pick it up. So then we go and we search the maximum price a couple of hundred lower, and I go and search them, and you'll notice, guys, that I am sticking to popular kits. And the one thing is, there is a big difference in the price that kits actually do quick sell for. These kits quick sell for between 50 and 60 coins, and that is a lot less than what they did in previous games. It was something around 270, I think, or 250 to 270 was the majority of kits. That's how much they'd be able to quick sell them for. So you'll find that a lot of kits go for 200 buy now, even with very, very good teams. So I would stick to mainly very popular teams. You'll see some of the cards that I do pick up, kits that I pick up, you'll notice that they are from popular teams. I picked Liverpool, Chelsea, Barcelona, Man United, a lot of the bigger popular teams, Real Madrid in there as well. You can sell them on for, because if the buy now on a kit is 200, you're not going to make any profit whatsoever. So make sure that the kit's value when you check its lowest buy now is around at least 450, but you can again do it with a lower amount, but again you are going to make a little profit off it. Now I must say, from the session that I done and what you will see coming up here, I did end up picking up quite a few kits, and I think I spent in total in and around 10k, I'd like to say, in and around that, and I did make just over 10k profit. So it basically doubles your the money that you invest into it. So I was so happy with the amount that I got back. You know, putting in 10k, getting 10k profit is absolutely amazing. And as you can see, Chelsea, Liverpool. But guys, don't let me basically put you off buying other kits, because it'll work with other teams, not just the team shown here. And especially when this video first comes out, it might be hard to pick these kits up, but what you need to do is just diversify yourself, try to pick other kits that go for quite an expensive price, and use this method, put it into play, bid on players right up to an hour, and leave it go, and you will make a serious amount of profit. I've made so much profit off this, and it is an absolutely great technique. You'll see the prices that I've sold for, so I'm not lying to you, I'm not just saying I'm picking them up for this price. And you did see all the prices I did pick them up for were very, very cheap, and I'm selling them on. And the good thing about them is they sell very fast, so it's quick, easy and effective profit. And that's exactly what you want when you are doing some quick trading. And this is a great method for you guys who have very little coins. You can do this with only a couple hundred coins, a couple of thousand, and it works perfectly, really. But that is it for this trading method video. I do hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you want to see more. But that is it for me, guys, so I will see you next time.